this here is what the front end looks like. Now, this is just one of our templates. MemberHub is a lot like WordPress. So once you get everything set up, you get all your content in there and your modules and everything, then with the click of a button, you can change out your template, okay? So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna come over here to one of the products that I literally created in maybe 2 minutes flat, okay? So this is kind of like the directory for those products, all right? And as you can see, our goal was to make it stupid simple, okay? So we didn't want to get complicated, like we are integrated with Canva and things of that nature and Usain and stuff that the members would expect, but our goal is for you to get set up as fast as you can. So the idea is you take one image that represents your product, you load it in there, and then boom, we go and do all of this for you. We put the titles on there, we carry that image throughout the whole entire site, so it looks banging, it looks sweet, right? So if I click on this module here, you're gonna see what it looks like inside. And this is just one template, right? So we have this beautiful menu over here. Here's how you get back to all of your products, and we've got a news feed for each membership, just all kinds of cool stuff, right? So here, these are just different layouts because you can choose different elements. And you can see that we've already brought in the image for you. Here's the title. And then down below, you can see I'm just kind of playing here. You can actually have action blocks as well. So you can have like step one, step two, step three. You can have like goal blocks. And then of course I have the related modules down here. So you can see how nice those look. So there's a lot of stuff you can do here. But if I come over here and look on this side, this is really cool, okay? So if I click this here, this is the resources. Now this specific module here doesn't have any resources, but let's find one that does, okay? So as you can see here, here's some external URLs. And that's how the resources come in. I'm gonna show you, we actually have a resource library. So you just kind of load everything up all at once, and then you kind of map your resources, right? If we come over here, here's the notes field. Now what's cool about this, as I'm playing this video, and if I come over here, and if I pause this, and I say, okay, I'm gonna come over here and make a note, all right? So I'm gonna say, Chad uses Shopify. Okay, now as soon as I hit record, check this out, guys. What it did is it not only recorded the note, but it recorded the exact time. So if I click this here, make it easy to remember, I click this and boom, it takes you directly to that spot in the video, right? So cool features like this, you're gonna find all the way through MemberHub. Here's a live chat over here, so you can start recent conversations. You can see other conversations going on. And then, guys, where MemberHub's strength is on the gamification. So you're able to go and assign badges and rewards and points when they complete goals. So you could have down here at the bottom, you could have a goal block that says, hey, we want you to go and register your domain name. And when you do, you're gonna get the domain name badge, or you're gonna get so many points. And then you actually can go and set it up to where if you hit 100 points, then you get the gold star badge. And when you get the gold star badge, then you're gonna get like a $100 Amazon gift certificate from us, right? So you actually get to go and assign prizes as well for when they reach those goals and those badges, right? Like the gamification is sick, the monetization is sick. You can have banners and you can have different text blocks, all kinds of cool stuff per page, not just per product, not just per membership, but per page, okay? So this all looks pretty sweet and everything. There's so much I can show you with this. If I come over here to store, each and every membership site is going to have its own store, right? So automatically they can come in here and they can go ahead and check out your other products. And so if they come over here and click learn more, then what that's gonna do is that's gonna open up to the sales page that was created for the Amazon Mastermind or for affiliate domination or for the $10,000 lead capture page. Now, the cool part about this, guys, we know that no matter what, the subscribers will make money. If they bring people in for free, right? Let's say that this course right here is for free. They bring people in and people go and click that link that I just clicked and they come in here and they see these other products and it's already all linked up to JVZoo or PayPal or whatever. The sales page is automatically created for them, right? We're doing everything for them. As soon as they create their membership site, their sales page is automatically created. Like we have done 95% of the work for them throughout this whole entire platform, okay? It is the most intense membership platform you guys have ever seen. Totally out of the box thinking, okay? So everything looks good on the front end, right? This is beautiful. Now check this out, guys. what I could do is, this is actually a template. This is what I mentioned with being similar to WordPress. So if I come back over here, this is actually what the back end looks like. So as you can see, I'm just going to show you this really quick because I know your time's valuable. If I come over here to theme selection, guys, we have these different themes. Okay, so right now I'm on this theme, but if I want to use this theme, I literally click the button. The theme has been loaded. I'm going to show you what we can do here with the builder. Okay, so if I come back over here and I refresh, bada bing, bada boom, we have a brand new theme, right? And so I can sit here and go through each and every one of these themes, and I can simply change them out. Like that fast, we can change out these themes. And we actually have more themes coming as I speak, right? Our goal was to have 100 themes. So like, check this out, right? Like, this is totally different. You can change out the colors. You can change out the images. It's all very easy. So how do we do this? Well, the first thing is, step one is, you're going to create your membership site. Okay, once you've done that, you're going to go ahead and choose your theme for your membership site. We've got all these themes here, but I'm going to go ahead and choose this one. That's definitely my favorite. Okay, and then once you've done that, you're going to go through this simple customization process. So like, I'm going to come over here and I'm going to say, okay, here's my theme, but what I want to do is I want to go ahead and swap out this image here, right? So I can go ahead and change this image if I want to, or whatever I want to do. And then we come over here and we have what are called predefined colors. So watch this, guys. I click this here and you can see that we're choosing the colors for them, right? So it's simple, no-brainer stuff. They're literally going to come in here, just point and click and say, okay, that's what I like. Now, if they don't like the predefined colors, then they can come over here and they can do custom colors, right? We also have patterns. So if they want to have patterns on their page, they can have patterns, right? Just all kinds of cool stuff here. And here's the custom colors. And then we have extra options for each template. So the idea is, once they choose their theme, then they're going to go through and they're going to spend 2 minutes customizing their whole entire template. And what we're doing is, we're coming up with a master template, okay? So they're going to change everything they want here and they're going to save it. And then once it's saved, they come over here to the membership pages and check this out, guys. Here's all the products I have, okay? But what if I just want to go and work on this one product? Well, we have this little menu here and I'm able to focus just on this one product. So now what I can do is, I can come over here and I can open up the pages that are inside this product. So how easy is it to create these pages? Guys, I literally did this in about 10 to 15 minutes, okay? Here is my product name right here. And I go ahead and click this here and I'm able to change out the thumbnail image or whatever. But remember, when we created the product, we simply say, okay, load your image, right? So we take that image, we use it for all the thumbnails, we use it for the video placeholders, we use it for the sales page, we use it for everything so that we're able to get you set up as fast as we can. And then if you choose to, if you want to go through here and change out that image each time, well, you have the power to do that, but you don't have to. Okay, so now you simply come over here. If we want to put a video on the main product page, we can do that. We just click the button here and we can go ahead and add a new video, right? We can pull in from YouTube, Vimeo, Wistia, Amazon S3, Dropbox, or just a generic video, right? And then here's how this works. If I want to put a video module down below, boom, I click this. If I want to put a content module down below, boom, I click this. If I want to do like a free giveaway page, I do that. If I want to go ahead and put a category down here, yes, we have categories, subcategories, I can do that, right? And then I can come over here and I can go ahead and set a level for this membership here. Or another thing you can do is, you can actually have packages inside your individual products. So if this product here has like 3 different levels, meaning we have a free ebook, that's one level. Then we have like video modules, that's another level. And then we have like an ebook, video modules, as well as live webinars. Well, then that there could be like your 3rd level, okay? So I'll show you that here in a minute, but let's stay right here. This is where you set your level. And then what we can do is, we can come over here to this related module settings, okay? And so what this does is, we can make this product appear on the pages tab, and that's where their store was. So we can decide if we want this product to appear in the store or not, because sometimes you're not gonna wanna do that because it's gonna be like a special promotion and you're just not gonna wanna do that, okay? And then over here, we can go ahead and delete the product. We can set it to active. We can see what the product looks like. We can go and clone the product, and then we can just drag and drop wherever we want, Okay, so if I click this here, then this appears right here. All right, so this is the name of the module. So as you can see, you can go ahead and overwrite the image and everything, description, title, everything you'd expect, okay? But check this out. If I come in here, guys, this is very easy, okay? This is what we call a action block, all right? So what happens is if I click this here, I can go ahead and pull in a video. I can have a opt-in form here, okay? Call to action, everything's here. So you simply come over here and you just customize your block really quick. And so then this block is going to appear on your page, right? So you can have as many blocks as you want. Matter of fact, you're gonna learn how this works. You're gonna be creating what are called goal blocks, okay? So they have a video module and your goal is to go register for a domain name. So what we wanna do is we wanna create a goal block for that page. So we have two different types of goal blocks. Some is simply say, okay, I want this goal block right here, okay? And then we're gonna go ahead and create a new goal block, right? And so we already have our goals specified. So we would go ahead and pull in the goal, because remember, a goal is tied to gamification. So you can set it up to where as soon as they complete the goal, they receive points, they receive a badge, all kinds of cool stuff, right? You can customize these blocks, you can customize the colors, the text, everything. You can have it to where the block is automatically open on that page, or you can have it to where it's closed. So you can have one that says step one, step two, step three, right? Tell me, guys, that this stuff is not awesome. If I come over here to the resources, I can click this right here. And guys, I can instantly bring in an existing resource. So if I want to bring in this resource right here, I can go ahead and click this. Okay, and I can say insert selected resource, and boom, there it is. So now this resource is not only appearing in the side menu, but you can also make it appear on your main page as well. Okay, so let's go ahead and go back over here. I think all this is pretty self-explanatory, right? This is where we add a resource. So if we want to add that resource for the main page, we can go ahead and do that. And then it's going to appear in that little side menu, okay? And then over here, this is how fast we can go and add a video, right? Everything is just stupid simple, guys. And then over here, this is where we go and we set up a package, not a level, okay? The level is on the product level, but inside that level, we have what are called packages. And then here's where we can go ahead and set the related module settings. So we could say, okay, disable this page from showing in related modules. Those were the little related boxes that you saw on the bottom of that page. Or we could say disable related modules on this page altogether. So when you open up this page, at the very bottom, there's not going to be any related modules showing. Or you can say disable this page from showing in the side menu, right? This is how you can go ahead and turn this page off on your main menu, okay? And then all this is pretty self-explanatory. This is where you active, this is where you view. Here's where we can go, we can drip feed content, right? Now, this gets really cool as well. So I click enable drip feed, and we can say, okay, when this page right here is completed and, guys, 3 days have passed, okay, and they've at least earned 25 points or they've received a certain badge, right? Once that happens, then and only then will they open up to the next module, right? So the drip feed is very, very goal related, something that you guys have never seen before, okay? So I'm gonna go ahead and close this here, and now I'm done with Amazon. But if I wanna come over here and look at all the products, guys, that's how fast we do that, right? We don't have pages and pages and pages and pages where you have to scroll through and do all this other stuff. No, you just come over here and you just choose the product that you're working on. Now, this is just one membership site, right? So you can have as many membership sites as you want. So like, here's my 10,000 lead capture page. If I wanna open this up, boom, there it is. They're all video modules, okay? Pretty cool. So now we're gonna come over here to the levels and packages. Watch this, guys. This is how fast you can go and create a level, right? So I've gone and I've created my level, or I can come over here and I can create a package, right? So I'm gonna choose my product, and then I'm gonna come over here and I have my package. And so when we were over here in the membership pages, all I was doing, if I open this up, I was just setting my package, right? And so the only package that will appear is one that is tied into the product, okay? So if I come back over here, that's how you create your levels and your packages. Very, very easy, stupid simple, okay? Now we come over here to other pages. These are pages that are not necessarily part of your membership site, but they're necessary. So you have like a support page. We've already got the template for you. You've got your newsfeed page, you got an about me page, my products page, here's the store page, privacy policy, terms and conditions. You can come over here and you can add your own pages, right? pretty cool stuff. There's one thing, let's see, let's come over here to sales pages, all right? So once you create a membership site, guys, then what happens is we have automatically gone and created the sales page for you, okay? So if I come over here and if I edit this one right here, this is the actual membership, okay? So let's come over here to a product real quick, all right? And if I click edit, you can see here's where I can change everything out. So I got my title, my description. Here's where I've gone and chosen the instructor. I'm going to show you where all that lives. Here's my image. Here's my logo. Okay, pretty self-explanatory. And then what we're able to do is we're able to change out the theme. So watch this, guys. I click theme settings. Okay, so here is my sales page currently, right? And so what I can do is I can come over here. This is the one I'm on. And I can go ahead and click this little green thing and check this out, guys. I can very easily just come over here and apply a different theme. I just click apply and bada bing, bada boom, it's gonna change out and there you go. That's that fast. Now, what they can do is they can come in here and they can customize this page later on when they start getting sales, but I'm gonna tell you what's gonna happen. Guys, they're gonna be setting up their membership sites and all of a sudden, they're gonna start getting sales instantly. It's gonna happen that fast because they have simply taken the time to create their membership site. And so what we have done is we've taken the time to create a sales page for each and every membership, as well as each and every product. So if I come over here and click on this guy, okay, now we're in a different one. Let's go ahead and choose this right here, okay? So I'll choose this, and here is my sales page. Notice how we went and pulled in the picture and everything. And then here is the packages that are included inside that product. Okay, so those are the different packages that I have set up. There's the prices and everything. And then you can have testimonials scrolling down here at the bottom. Now check this out. The way you get testimonials is it's included inside your membership, okay? On your module pages, they have a little thing that says, leave your testimonial for this course or for this product. And when you do, you're gonna receive so many points, right? It's just awesome, guys. So the sales pages happen automatically. All right. So everybody says, why is it taking you guys so long to create MemberHub? Now you guys are starting to understand, right? We really went above and beyond with this piece of software. It's just amazing and it does so much automatically. Now, we're going to get into a little bit of advanced settings, okay? Because I think you guys understand this is how you go and you change out your sales pages. And by the way, if I come back in there, let me just come over here to sales pages real quick before we go to optional settings. We can just come over here and do the same exact thing, right? We can come over here and we can edit the description. So if we want to add extra stuff to the sales page, we can do that. We can bring in our blocks. We can do everything I just showed you a minute ago. And then we can come over here and we can go ahead and control the testimonials that show up on that page. Okay, so we just click assign testimonial and it'll go ahead and bring in any testimonials you have. By the way, you can add testimonials yourself. This is the quote that appears on the top of the page. Okay, we just made this very easy. Or if you don't want to use our sales page at all, you click this here and you can go ahead and have your own sales page. So if you're using InstaBuilder or ClickFunnels or something like that, we're going to go ahead and link your own sales page to the actual products inside the software. And then over here, if you don't want your sales page to appear in the store, well, boom, we can turn it off. If you don't want your sales page to appear inside the My Products page, we can turn it off. And then if we want to click and look at the actual sales page, we can go ahead and do that. Now, if I open this up, this shows me the package that we created for this product. And so what I can do is I can say, okay, stop the package from showing on the sales page as well, right? So you have complete control what you want happening, right? Here's another package and I can go ahead and turn that off, okay? So now let's really have some fun here, okay? So obviously we come over here to system settings. Yes, you can map your CNAME, your domain name and everything. You can come over here, you can turn off comments on your page, your site, whatever you wanna do. SMTP settings, yeah, we're tied in with email, everything else. SSL settings, just stuff that you guys would expect to see. We also have a built-in affiliate program with MemberHub, so you can go out there and have other people promote your memberships and your products and your second tier percentages. All kinds of cool stuff, right? But here's where it gets really interesting, guys. Check this out. I come over here to optional settings and be prepared to be blown away, okay? So the first thing is I'm gonna come over here to manage resource. And we have what's called a resource library. So how this works is you come over here and you choose your product and then you just go ahead and you start loading resources inside the library. So I come over here, I click add new resource, okay? And then I have the option. I can go ahead and type the name of the resource, a description, and then I can choose, is it downloadable content? If it is, I'm gonna go ahead and choose the file to upload. Is there an external URL? If there is, we're gonna go ahead and put that there. Or maybe it's just a note. Now remember, all of these things right here are going to appear in your little side menu over here, right? So this here is inside my resource library, right? So you just go and you bulk load your resources, and then what you do is you come over here and you map your resources to the specific products. Now, once we have a library, then we can go and we can pull in these resources to any product. So if I click Create Link, okay, so you can see here are the modules. So I simply say, okay, let's make that resource appear here and let's make it appear here. And then it's going to appear in that side menu, right? Pretty cool stuff, okay? You can hear the excitement in my voice, right? I just love this platform. Okay, so that is managed resources. Now, be really prepared to be, actually, I don't want to go there yet. Let's come over here to manage instructors. So what you guys can do is you come over here, let's add a new instructor, right? So we can come over here and we can say Karthik Ramani, okay? And now we can go ahead and put a little bio about him. And then what you're able to do is you're able to assign that instructor to specific products, right? So you can see here is my bio, right? So that's exactly what it looks like. So it's tied to all my products. Okay, pretty cool, pretty cool, pretty cool. We can come over here to manage testimonials. Check this out, guys. This is where your testimonials automatically come in. So somebody goes and assigns a testimonial. By the way, it can be a video testimonial as well. You can filter it by different products, okay? And so what you do is you come over here, you can edit the testimonial, you can reject the testimonial, whatever you want to do. But remember, these testimonials are what we're using on your sales page. So they're automatically created on their own, okay? We come over here to monetization, guys. We're still beefing this up, but you're able to come in here and you're able to set banners for specific pages, just all kinds of cool stuff you can do, right? We're gonna have video blocks, we're gonna have all kinds of stuff. We're still trying to figure out the monetization with the templates and everything, but don't worry about it, that'll be done, okay? So we did the monetization, we did the managed resource, we did the managed instructors, we did managed testimonials. Now, watch this, guys. Here's where the real magic comes in. I'm gonna come over here to this gamification tab. I'm telling you, be prepared to be blown away, okay? So what I can do is I can choose Amazon Mastermind, all right? Now, what I can do is I can create a new badge. So I'm gonna call this Amazon Superstar, okay? Now, what we have to decide is what kind of badge is this? Is this a badge based off points, or is this a badge when you complete a task? So I'm gonna say this is a points badge, okay? And then what I'm able to do, guys, is I'm able to choose a reward when they receive this badge. So I'm gonna go ahead and click save, all right? Notice how fast everything is. Nothing's sitting here spinning like other membership sites, right? Okay, so now that badge has been created. Now I'm gonna go ahead and add another badge. This time we're gonna say Amazon store. Okay, that means we set up a store, okay? And this one's going to be based off a task badge. And if I want, I can go ahead and set another reward, but I'm just gonna leave that alone for now, okay? Now, we set up our badges. Next thing is we come over here to our goals, okay? So we're gonna create a new goal. Set up your Amazon store, okay? And we come over here to description. Following the video module, set up your Amazon store. Okay, and then we can go ahead and choose a video once again, right? Now we can have it to where there's a field that's going to appear down below. So we can say like this, place your Amazon store link in the field below. Okay, and so now they'll go ahead and type that in the input field. And then what we get to do is we get to say, okay, once they do that, we're gonna issue this badge right here. Or we can say, let's go ahead and issue 10 points. Now, also guys, check this out. You know, all those high ticket coaching programs and everything where, you know, you get in here and you're inside of a membership site, you know, you paid $5,000, $10,000, whatever, and they have goals and you're supposed to do this, you're supposed to do that. Well, check this out. Once they complete their goal, you can have it to where they can't advance until you go and actually approve what they've done. So you can stop them from moving forward until you approve this goal. It's perfect for high ticket programs, right? So we're gonna go ahead and click, I'm gonna uncheck that, I'm gonna click save. Okay, so now you can see here are the badges that I just went and created. Now we're going to come over here to automation, okay? So check this out, guys. Here's what we get to do. Here's where we set the automated badges, right? This just takes a little bit of getting used to. So I'm going to click this here, add new badge, and I'm going to say, okay, when the total points reach 100, then remember this badge that we created right here? We're going to go ahead and assign the Amazon Superstar badge. This badge gets issued automatically. So how do they earn points? Well, watch this, guys. We're going to give them 20 points when they finish watching a video module. We're going to give them 5 points when they go and download a resource. We're going to give them 10 points when they post a comment. We're going to give them 10 points when they like something. We're going to give them 30 points when they give us a video testimonial. And we're going to give them 20 points when they go and give us a written testimonial. And we're going to go ahead and click save. And then we can come over here and add a new badge. We can say, okay, when they hit 200 points, we're going to give them the super duper superstar badge, right? So you can just keep going and going and going. And what that does is that encourages engagement with your site. And especially when you're able to go and give them rewards. So if I come in here to the rewards section, look at this, guys. Here is the reward that I've gone and issued. So if I come over here and click add new reward, it's very simple. I just come over here and I say an Amazon gift card. Okay, and then I go ahead and type in the description, and then I'm gonna say, okay, is the reward a download? Is it a URL? Or is there just a note with like a coupon code or something, right? Okay, so once you create your library of rewards, guys, then you're able to tie everything to your goals and your gamification, all right? And it all just kind of ties together. And there's so much more I can show you with MemberHub. Like, we're just getting started, right? Like, you can come over here, you can automatically add your members, you can export your members. The security in this thing is just unbelievable. We've heard about a lot of vulnerabilities with the recent plugins and membership softwares that have been launched. I'm not going to mention any names, but I know you guys know exactly what I'm talking about. And I just want to show you, because I think it's very important, right? If I just come over here to the homepage, and if I just click on some of these products here, guys, I mean, this is beautiful, right? Look how fast this is. It's like, boom, it opens right up. And boom, this one opens right up. I mean, it's fast. There's no delays. There's nothing spinning here. It is instant. You have complete control. You're able to change out the whole entire template on the fly. All your products are automatically turned into sales pages. You're going to have complete idiots using MemberHub that are going to be making money with it because we have done the whole entire thing. You can literally click on a button that says create a video module, and all you have to do is just choose your video, and we do all of this for you.